What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to play Minecraft Modpacks through ATLauncher. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Minecraft is a highly customizable game that a lot of players have taken advantage of by creating or using mods, and there sure are a lot of them. Luckily, large collections of mods, known as modpacks, make it easy to install a big group all at once, but the default launcher doesn't have a user-friendly interface to start the process. This is where third-party launchers come in, with one of them being ATLauncher. Using this allows you to install or import almost any pack, log into multiple accounts, and create custom profiles for your gameplay. Let's go over exactly how to use it. Head to ATLauncher's download page and then select an option for your operating system. Find the file and then open it to start the process, and you can continue to follow the prompts and set your installation directory. After that, you can press finish to automatically boot up the launcher. And after you wait for updates to download, you can select your language in the following prompt. When you're done, click save at the bottom to finish the install. Now, before attempting to use any mod packs, you're going to need to add a Minecraft account to the launcher. This is typically done with your Microsoft details due to the Mojang migration. Head towards the account section near the right-hand side, and then you can enter your username and password, or you can choose to log in with Microsoft. Make sure to confirm any prompts that appear, and then you'll be able to switch your account. Once everything is correctly set up, you can start installing any modpack you want from the launcher. The most popular way to install modpacks in ATLauncher is directly finding them in the program. This means you can search for it in their system to quickly and easily download the pack. On the right-hand side of the launcher, enter the Packs area, and then to the left, you can select your desired service from the category list. Use the Search or the other fields near the top to find your modpack, and then once you find it, you can click New Instance to create a profile for the mods. Next, just enter a new name and click Install to start downloading the files. We don't recommend changing the server version, but it is optional. Afterwards, continue to press OK when it's done, and then head into the Instances tab. From here, you can press Play to begin enjoying your newly installed modpack. As for the other method, players who already have a modpack in mind can import it from the pack's URL or with its downloaded zip file. This means if you found one on CurseForge or another service, then simply copying the link and importing it is all that's required. Head towards the Instances area and then click Import at the top left corner. Either paste your modpack's URL or browse your computer for a zip file, and then afterwards you can press Import to begin the download. If it's successful, continue to name the profile and install the modpack. Just like before, when it's done, you can return to the Instances tab and click Play on the pack. If you're having a difficult time finding a modpack, then you can try using the additional search fields. For instance, changing the Minecraft version or sorting through filters might help you find the pack. Otherwise, you can use databases such as CurseForge to look up the ones that you want, and then you can use the import method to download it on ATLauncher. In cases where importing a modpack doesn't work, you might not be using a supported URL or you have an incorrect zip file. For example, only links from CurseForge, Modrinth, and MultiMC are currently compatible with this method. If your game crashes after installing it, the most common reason is that your launcher doesn't have enough RAM, which is solved by reviewing our guide that will be linked down below. Besides this, packs can encounter internal issues and require a different version to be used before installing it. This is accomplished by deleting your broken instance and then re-downloading it with a newer version in the Version to Install option. Modpacks are confusing, but having a dedicated launcher makes things run a lot smoother and it makes it way easier to set up in the first place. Take out all of the guesswork by downloading straight from the search bar or upload your own through the import options and you'll be playing in no time. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe. or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.